हेलो क्लास, आई एम राशिद खान फ्रॉम लक्ष्मी प्रसाद मेमोरियल पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। क्लास टुडे द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 11 दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन, इन विच असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन द रिमेनिंग पोर्शन ऑन विच वी हैव टू डिस्कस एंड दैट इज वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम स्पोर फॉर्मेशन। So the spore formation is the process by which the plant can grow through the forming spores. That means they do not require any type of seeds, leaves, roots, stem or any other plant parts or vegetative parts by which they can be grown. They can be grown by the forming spores. You have seen in case of a buds, that is a process of budding. Budding is the another process in which the bud formation takes place. But in case of spore formation, there is a spore form and through which the new plant can grow. You have seen in case of a small bulging like structure or wherever in case of rhizobium or in case of rhizopus form, suppose there is a spore formation takes place in case of bread. There is a bread mold formation takes place in case of a bread. How they can form the spores? You have seen a bread on which the black color appearances. May get formed. Suppose like this, if the bread forms, so there will be a black spot on them. You have seen like this black spot. These black spots are known as spores. You have seen many times this can form a long chain of spores by the means of spore can form, and this can be concluded like that. This may have a number of spores. Now we have to study in details. Suppose if there is a sporangium, so this one is what? These are called as sporangiophores. Here is a spores. So this one is sporangium. singularly it is called as sporangium, but it is called as sporangia in plural form. And this can have number of spores in them. Spores. These are what? These are rhizoids. These are called as a rhizoids. Here is sporangiophores. So there is a number of spore formation, and through which each spore is able to grow a new plant through the spores. Spores are those particular type of a plant part which can be grow a new plant when there is a capable or when there is a favorable conditions occur. These spores can grow into new plants. So suppose if there is a spore formation takes place, that is in another form of spore, that is in another form of a asexual type of a reproduction. So it is another form of a reproduction through which a new plant can germinated or grows. Now the second process or the second types of the vegetative reproduction is called the budding. Budding is another means of reproduction by which plant may get formed by the formation of a buds. The buds, in case of a yeast, you can see there is a bulges appearance takes place on the parent body, and then the parent body grows a new bulges on its top, and again here the bulges may get separate from its parent body. Firstly, the nucleus divided into the two equal half, one into the parent body and one into the bulges form. So new bulge form, and when after forming the nucleus, it will form a complete a new cells, that is a buds, which is get separated into the new plants, and each buds in that case is form a new plant. That is a non-greenish plant. It is called a yeast. So you can see the example of budding in case of a yeast. Budding in yeast may also form, forever you can see, takes place. Suppose there is, if there is a yeast cell and it is the nucleus in which it can be, and again there is a bulges takes place. A bulges forms and this nucleus elongated. Then from these cells, the elongations may be forwarded as, and the nucleus may elongate it and separate it, and again it will form two cells, each of one them. In case from these parts two separate cells are formed. These two separate cells are called as a daughter cells. This is called daughter cell. Daughter cells. So from the mother plant are from the mother cells, there is a bulges firstly developed, and these bulges acquire a part of a nucleus from the nucleus as well. Why? Because there is an elongation of the nucleus takes place, and again this nucleus is separated. By the separating of a nucleus, these bulges get separated from there and form a new cells. So the new cells formation takes place in that case is two equal half. and in each case these two daughter cells get formed. From these such type of likewise changes, there is another form of a yeast get formed. A number of changes, a number of yeast bud formation takes place. That process is called as bud. So we can say here is a bud forming. There is a bud forming, and again this bud develop into the new young ones. The chain of yeast may be formed, and from this there is a number of cells get formed. Likewise, there is a each and every yeast cells get developed into the new ones, and through which there is a number of yeast cell might be formed. So we can say it is a type of asexual reproduction in which one single parent can form a same type of a number of a different non-greenish plant called as a buds. Whenever the favorable conditions and the nutrients proper amount are available, these buds grows into the number of cells. So these number of cells of a yeast in case may form through the formation of a yeast, that one is called bud, and the process is called budding. So budding in that form you can see in case of a yeast, budding in yeast. This is the budding in yeast. Now we can move on to the next one. The next is fragmentation. Fragmentation means what? There is a fragmentation. Fragmentation is another process by which it can be grows into the new ones. It is a type of a asexual reproduction. So it can be formed different type of a fragments, and each fragment grows into the new plants. It is a greenish plant like a algae. Suppose Spirogyra is a form of a algae which can be developed into the new plant. And you can see in case of a Spirogyra, Spirogyra is a form of algae which can be developed into the new cells or the new plants by cleavage or breaking down into the many pieces. These are the cells of Spirogyra, and they make a cleavage or broken down into the many pieces, and each separate piece can develop into the new one. Each separate piece can develop into the new ones. Likewise, each and particular portion or part of these Spirogyra will have to develop into the new one by cleavaging as well, by forming the fragments. These can be broken down into the different fragments. The Spirogyra get broken into different fragments, and each fragment has to develop into new plants. So that one is called as a process of fragmentation. In case of a fragmentation, the part, each part can develop into the new one, and through which the new plant can be germinated. Now these are the different forms of asexual reproduction. In case there is a binary fission, I have already told you about the binary fission. The binary fission is another form of asexual reproduction. Binary fission is a type of asexual reproduction in which binary means two equal halves. Fission means cleavage or broken, breaking into parts or cleaves into the parts. So what we can say, if the any body is cleavage or broken into two equal halves, and each and every equal part has to be developed into the new ones, new young ones. So such type of a reproduction is called as a binary fission. In case of amoeba, you may have seen a parent body. This parent body has to be developed into the new ones, new young ones. How they can be possible? There is a nucleus firstly elongated, and through which the constrictions may take place. The elongations of nucleus firstly, through which constrictions may form at the center, and now there is a complete developed nucleus formed, and now this one has to be formed each and every part of this. It has to be broken into the new one. Then two daughter cells, like this may have formed the two daughter cells, and these can be developed by forming two different forms of binary fission, that is a cleavage. So firstly, what we can say, fully grown amoeba here, this one is the cytoplasm. These are the cytoplasm, and this can, you know, nucleus. So in each and every cases this could be formed. Likewise, next other part of a plant, they can be emerged from this particular